Everybody, it's Sam. This is the last time I'm going to do this. If the camera goes off again, I'm just going to scream and give up. I'm just going to try to go through these as fast as I possibly can. I read Laurel and McDaniel's Now I Lay Me Down to Sleep. I did like this. Every one of her books, though, they focus on kids with cancer or some kind of disease. And half the time, they always die. Sometimes they do live. In this one, a girl and a boy meet. They do fall in love, but she doesn't want to accept it. One of them, yes, dies. I'm not saying which one, but one of them does. Then I read Hooked Up for Murder by Robert Melendinich and Michael Benson. I believe the boy that was charged with murder was framed. There's two of them, but one of them, I believe, actually did it. But John Guga, I think he was the one that was framed by the other boy. I don't remember the other boy's name, Andrew or something. Don't remember. But I believe he was framed. Him. Oh, wait. Before I forget. This book wasn't on Goodreads. I mean, it was, but not the cover. I had to go all over Google to find it and put it on there myself. And then I read A Stolen Life by J.C. Dugard. I'm just going to say that. I think I've already talked about them three, this and them other two, on one of my TBR videos. Just go on one of my TBR videos. It's just about her getting kidnapped and held for 18 years and having two kids by her abductor. From she was 14 and I think 18, 17 or 18 when she had her second child. And then I read Rock and Roll Love Stories, True Tales of the Passion and Drama Behind the Stage Acts by Gil Paul. I somewhat liked this one, but I somewhat didn't, because every one of them, I think except maybe one or two, they stayed together. Everyone else, though, didn't. And I feel also really bad because they kept blaming her for his drug addiction. If I'm not mistaken, he was already a drug addict before he met with her. That's what everybody else was saying. And supposedly they were really, really in love with each other, so I'm not going to blame her for him. I think he ends up killing himself after he kills her. That's the only thing I remember. Sid Vicious and Nancy. I can't remember her last name. Sid Vicious and Nancy. It mentions a bunch of people, though. From Johnny Cash and June Carter. Ike and Tina. Elvis Presley and Priscilla. Bob Dylan and Joan Baez. Can't really pronounce that. Sonny and Cher. George Harrison and Patty Boyd. Mick Jagger and Marianne Faithfull. Kurt Cobain and Courtney Love, Sid Vicious and Nancy Spudgeon, Debbie Harry and Chris Stein, Lou Reed and Laurie Anderson, James Taylor and Carly Simon, Serge Gainsbourg and Jane Birkin, John Lennon and Yoko Ono. Now, I know them two stay together. He was murdered. I think it's the only ones I mentioned here. Kurt Cobain and Courtney Love. I think even though he committed suicide, she actually really hated him for doing that because she was still in love with him. She probably would have given him another chance if he would have gotten off drugs. The way the story set out in there. That's all I read. And before I forget, I'm reading this right now. Goosebumps Ghost Camp, number 45. That's what I'm reading right now. Oh, I'm also kind of reading this right now, too. The Perfect Stranger by Megan Miranda, and this is from the library. So far, I'm actually really enjoying her books. I might end up buying them sometime. That's all I've got to say right now. I hope you enjoy this video, and the only reason I'm talking so low is because my niece is sleeping. I hope you guys can hear me. Well, that's all I gotta say. Bye.